time for another video then, isn't it? It's my, did I tell you I had a new camera? I can't remember if I said I had a new camera. It's a new camera. So lighting should be a bit better. It's especially good in low light, was it? It's early, I'm tired. I thought I might as well show you some of the orders I've got going on at the moment. Got some orders completed, ready for delivery or collection. Got some owls, a cockerel, a guitar, rat rods, dragonflies, hummingbirds, we've got all sorts going on. But I figured, for today's video, I've never shown you how I make the hummingbirds. Wow, I really look bold. Yeah, so we're gonna make a hummingbird today. I'll show you how the process I go through for doing that. Yeah, hope you enjoy it. Yeah, so that's the first part of how I do the hummingbird. That is making the head and the beak. I'll show you here. Right, that was three separate nuts and then a bolt on the end. Weld them all together, with build up some extra weld onto it, and then shape it with a flap disc on the angle grinder. And it gives you the nice shape of the head. So that's the main part of the hummingbird done. I've just got to make the flower that it feeds on now. Well, that's a hummingbird done. I thought I was filming on the last bit when I colour the wings with heat, so you add a nice like bluey gold iridescent colour to the wings. I thought I was filming, but I wasn't, so I missed that bit. Sorry. Anyway, this is the finished hummingbird. There's a bit more clean up to do on the base. Once that's done, then I would put a couple of coats of a clear acrylic lacquer on it to finish it off. So you can see all the wings and the nice flower. There it is. That's the hummingbird done. Another one ticked off the list for my orders. Hopefully the customer will be nice and happy with that. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to subscribe. There's lots more videos coming. Hopefully the battery won't run out on the camera halfway through next time. And have a good day.